my voice, I claim you as my choice. Be still and know I am here. I am hope for all who are hopeless. I am light for all who long to see. In the shadows of the night, I will be your light. Come and rest in me. Do not be afraid, I am with you. I have called you each by name. Come and follow me, I will bring you home. I love you and you are mine. I am strength for all the despairing, healing for the ones who dwell in shame. All the blind will see, the lame will all run free, and all will know my name. Do not be afraid, I am with you. I have called you each by name. Come and follow me, I will bring you home. I love you and you are mine. I am the word that leads all to freedom. I am the peace the world cannot give. I will call your name, embracing all your pain. Stand up now, walk and live. Do not be afraid, I am with you. I have called you each by name. Follow me, I will bring you home. I love you and you are mine.
Morning, everybody. Please stand and welcome Father Carlos. We're singing Sing a New Song.
Sing a new song unto the Lord. Let your song be sung from mountain high. Sing a new song unto the Lord, singing Alleluia. Trumpet sound. Sing a new song unto the Lord. Let your song be sung from mountains high. Sing a new song unto the Lord, singing Alleluia. Rise, O children, from your sleep. Your Savior now has come. He has turned your sorrow, your soul with song. Sing a new song unto the Lord. Let your song be sung from mountains high. Sing a new song unto the Lord, singing Alleluia.
Welcome to Sacred Heart Church. I'm Father Carlos Alvarez, your pastor. It's great to have you, whether you're here with us in person or joining us via our YouTube transmission. Today is the fifth Sunday of Easter. Yesterday we celebrated First Holy Communion, and I forgot to tell folks that Saturday morning Mass doesn't count for Sunday. But nonetheless, we have at least three of our young men who received First Holy Communion, two brothers there, Gabriel over here, and others that I may have missed. So welcome back, and congratulations to you and your families on your First Holy Communion. Today we offer the Holy Sacrifice of the Mass for the health and welfare of Brecken Ezekiel Bratcher Wilkinson, for the eternal happiness of the soul of D. Albert, Catherine Arguello, Felix Arguello, Melanie Martinez, Leonard Archuleta, Mike Borda, Admiral in U.S. Navy, Deborah Martinez, Teresa Martinez, Celia Martinez, all the Catholic daughters, the members of the Sangre de Cristo Court, 1810, and Viola Vigil. I don't know if she was a Catholic daughter or not, but she was very active in our parish, and so we pray for her as well. She died recently. And for all of your intentions. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, the Lord be with you. My brothers and sisters, we hear about the vineyard. We hear about the vine grower, the vine, and the branches. We come before God, who is the vine grower. We come with humble and contrite hearts. We know that we sin, we trust in God's infinite mercy. Let us pray. Almighty, ever-living God, constantly accomplish the Paschal mystery within us, that those you were pleased to make new in holy baptism may under your protective care bear much fruit and come to the joys of life eternal. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever.
A reading from the Acts of the Apostles. When Saul arrived in Jerusalem, he tried to join the disciples, but they were all afraid of him, not believing that he was a disciple. Then Barnabas took charge of him and brought him to the apostles, and he reported to them how he had seen the Lord, and that he had spoken to him, and how in Damascus he had spoken out boldly in the name of Jesus. He moved about freely with them in Jerusalem and spoke out boldly in the name of the Lord. He also spoke and debated with the Hellenists, but they tried to kill him. And when the brothers learned of this, they took him down to Caesarea and sent him on his way to Tarsus. The church throughout all Judea, Galilee, and Samaria was at peace. It was being built up and walked in the fear of the Lord. And with the consolation of the Holy Spirit, it grew in numbers. The word of the Lord.
Shall bow down before him.
I will praise you, Lord, in the assembly of your people. To him alone shall bow down all who sleep in the earth. Before him shall bend down all who go down into the dust. I will praise you, Lord, in the assembly of your people. And to him my soul shall live, my descendants shall serve him. Let the coming generation be told of the Lord, that they may proclaim to a people yet to be born the justice he has shown. I will praise you, Lord, in the assembly of your people.
A reading from the first letter of St. John. Children, let us love not in word or speech, but in deed and truth. Now this is how we shall know that we belong to the truth and reassure our hearts before him in whatever our hearts condemn For God is greater than our hearts and knows everything. Beloved, if our hearts do not condemn us, we have confidence in God and receive him from him whatever we ask, because we keep his commandments and do what pleases him. And his commandment is this: we should believe in the name of his Son, Jesus Christ, and love one another just as he commanded us. Those who keep his commandments remain in him, and he in them. And the way we know that he remains in us is from the Spirit he gave us. The word of the Lord.
Lord be with you. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to John. Jesus said to his disciples, "I am the true vine, and my Father is the vine grower. He takes away every branch in me that does not bear fruit. And everyone that does, he prunes, so that it bears more fruit. You already pruned because of the word that I spoke to you. Remain in me as I remain in you. Just as a branch cannot bear fruit on its own unless it remains on the vine, so neither can you unless you remain in me. I am the vine, you are the branches. Whoever remains in me and I in him will bear much fruit, because without me you can do nothing. Anyone who does not remain in me will be thrown out like a branch and wither. People will gather them and throw them into a fire, and they will be burned. If you remain in me, and my words remain in you, ask whatever you want, and it will be done for you. By this is my Father glorified, that you bear much fruit and become my disciples." The Gospel of the Lord. Those of you from Alamosa, there's a quick quiz, but I want you to raise your hand high. If you knew Sister Johnette Sawyer OSB, raise your hand. Sister Johnette. Okay, we're about 50% or less. That's okay. She was born in the city of Pueblo. She was not a cradle Catholic, and perhaps she went to Catholic school and met some of the Benedictine nuns. And during her youth, we had a Catholic president, President Kennedy, and many people who were not Catholic came into the Catholic Church because they saw that Catholics don't have horns on their heads and their heads don't spin around. So she came into full communion in the church. And not only that, she became a Benedictine sister at the Mount St. Scholastica Monastery in Chicago. They served in this diocese, in this parish as well. So I met her when I was a child. My father was a volunteer and certified catechist for the diocese in our home parish and worked with Sister Jeannette. So when I received my first Holy Communion, Sister Jeannette came to our first communion party in my cousin's home, which was my cousin Kathy, my brother Dominic, and I, three of us on that wonderful day. So again, congratulations to those who made their first Holy Communion yesterday and their families. Welcome. And Sister Jeannette not only worked here at Sacred Heart in Alamosa, she worked at our Sacred Heart Cathedral in Pueblo, my home parish, her home parish, St. Leander in Pueblo, and she also worked at St. Joseph in Monte Vista, if not the whole San Juan community at a time. So she was pretty well known in the diocese. Worked here for many years. About 3 years ago, she was called back to the mother house, and unfortunately, a year ago, she died of COVID alone, unfortunately, in a hospital room by herself, which is so ironic because she led a life of communion with her Benedictine sisters and the people that she served in mostly pastoral music, pastoral ministry. She was a very accomplished musician, and she gave, throughout her life, she gave free music lessons. And many of those people who received free music lessons continue to serve in the church and still serve in the church decades later. You know, I can think of Claudia Cordova, her last name's Cordova. Anyway, she's one example. She started playing piano when she was about this tall. She couldn't even, her feet didn't even hit the floor from the bench, and she's still active in her music ministry to this day. And there are others like her, many others like her that I can think of, whose names I forget, but they can still think of. So it's really just a wonderful example of what we hear in the gospel. Jesus talked to his disciples, but at the end of the gospel, he asked them to become disciples. And so what's that about? We had Father Matthew and Dr. Seth Wright here a week ago, Thursday, Friday, and Saturday of last week. And they talked about the transition from becoming a parish that maintains its institutional presence to becoming missionary disciples. And that's really the process that Jesus is inviting his disciples in today's gospel. I mean, they're already their disciples. Some of the apostles were married and had children, and they left their wives and their children to follow Jesus. And other of the disciples left their homes and their livelihoods to follow Jesus. And so Jesus is calling them to another level of discipleship, where 11 of the 12 disciples were martyred. Only John, the beloved apostle, wasn't martyred. The other 11 apostles were. So is that the kind of discipleship God's calling us to? Not necessarily to foreign missions, but he is definitely calling us to a deeper discipleship. And it looks like what we heard in the first reading. In the Acts of the Apostles, we hear that the disciples were afraid of Saul of Tarsus with his new Christian name, Paul, because he had been persecuting the church, and now he was the evangelizer of the church. Though he wasn't one of the 12, he was considered an apostle, the apostle to the Gentiles. They were afraid because they thought, well, this is a ruse, and he's just going to turn it on us, and he's going to persecute us, and we'll be martyred like St. Stephen that we hear about in the Acts of the Apostles. And that wasn't true. There was a true conversion of heart with Saul of Tarsus. And so it's that pattern of what we heard in the first reading, that he encountered Jesus on the road to Damascus. And it's this encounter with Jesus that shifts us from simple discipleship to missionary discipleship. Father Matthew spoke very beautifully about a young girl whose mother would give bread to the homeless who came to their back door. And inspired by her mother's charity, she wanted to become a religious sister. But she lived in an Eastern European country with no religious communities. So she went to another country and became a sister. From there, after that, they sent her to another country where she taught. And she was a nun teaching children in a Catholic school. But in an encounter with Jesus, Jesus asked her to serve the poorest of the poor. So within her religious community, she asked permission to do this, and they denied that position. They said, "We're teachers. We don't work with the poorest of the poor." So she started her own religious community, the Missionaries of Charity, and then the Priest of Charities for men. And we know her as St. Teresa of Calcutta. She was a good Catholic, but she had this encounter with Jesus, and faithful to that, she became a missionary disciple to bring Jesus to the poorest of the poor. St. Juan Diego is another example of that. He was a good Catholic, living out his Catholic life in greater Mexico City area, the state of Mexico, his home community of Ecatepec. But he was called to more, and he became a missionary disciple of Jesus Christ through Our Lady of Guadalupe, you know, through the means of Our Lady of Guadalupe. And so that's sort of the call that we have ourselves, like St. Paul, like St. Teresa of Calcutta, like St. Juan Diego, is to take our encounters with Jesus and to share them. And through small groups and faith sharing, bring back the 3/4 of our Catholic community that chooses not to worship with us every Sunday. And then others who may be interested in the Catholic Church. So that's the invitation today. And it's a very organic thing, really, when you think about it. And Jesus says that very clear in the gospel. The Father is the vine grower. Jesus says, "I am the vine, you are the branches." In our first reading, we hear about the consolation of the Holy Spirit, and then we hear about the Holy Spirit in the gospel. So it's the Holy Spirit's like the soil, the sun, and the water that gives growth to this vine. So we have an image of the Trinity, an allusion to the Trinity, to help this organic body of Christ grow. My last parish, close by, we had vineyards in Palisade, and it's kind of part of Colorado wine country. But here we grow potatoes. Potatoes are a cousin of the vine. They're not exactly grapes, but they're a cousin to vines and vine growing. So we can understand that from all of the tubers that we grow and harvest here. So it's an organic image that works for us here in the San Luis Valley, obviously. And so it's very appealing to think about the fact that the Father, the Son, and the Spirit are working through us to bear fruit, to bear potatoes, if you will, in our valley, okay? So with that in mind, I want to make myself available as you form your small groups, and I'd like to meet with your small groups and just give a blessing. And we're working on getting pictures of the image of the Sacred Heart of Jesus, so that each group will have an image of our local church as they gather and they share stories of faith and build up one another in faith. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and will be forever. Amen. I did forget to mention one example of missionary discipleship. Viola V. Hill was one of the women who worked on that tapestry of Our Lady of Guadalupe that's in Our Lady of Guadalupe Chapel as you enter the church. And she also began a prayer group together with Paul and Billy Stong that continues to this very day. They began it decades ago. Continues this very day at Thursday, Sat, 1 o'clock. So just a local example of a missionary disciple who bore much fruit. And we pray for her as her funeral services are being held as we speak. Thank you. During the seasons of Lent and Easter, Holy Mother Church encourages us to profess the Apostles' Creed. Together, let us profess our faith. I believe in God, the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth, and in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended into hell. On the third day he rose again from the dead. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of God, the Father Almighty. From there he will come to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and life everlasting. Amen. As branches of Christ, the true vine, we turn through him and the Holy Spirit to our Heavenly Father with our prayers.
For proclaimers of the good news, and for all who share their time, talent, and treasure, let us pray to the Lord. For wise leaders of the world's nations, and for careful stewards of the earth's resources, let us pray to the Lord. For high school seniors and college seniors preparing for graduation and for the parents and teachers who have guided them, let us pray to the Lord. For abundant blessings on this community gathered in the truth and for a renewed commitment to the deeds of justice, let us pray to the Lord. That we may seek Jesus in the poorest of the poor throughout the world, let us pray to the Lord. For those whose ministries and contributions help to support and to grow our parish, that God will continue to bless and prosper them in all they do, let us pray to the Lord. For the attentions we celebrate at this Mass, D. Albert, Catherine Argule, Felix Argule, Melanie Martinez, Leonardo Achulera, Mike Borda, Admiral U.S. Navy, Deborah Martinez, Teresa Martinez, Cecilia Martinez, all Catholic daughters, members of the Sangre de Cristo Court, 1810, and for the people of our parish, and for the intentions we hold in the silence of our hearts. May God graciously hear us through the Sacred Heart of Jesus. Let us pray to the Lord.
We also pray for the eternal happiness of the soul of Viola B. Hill and for the health and welfare of Brecken Ezekiel Bratcher Wilkinson. We pray to the Lord. We also remember Father James J. McDivitt, a priest of our diocese, who died on this date in 2006. We pray to the Lord. Heavenly Father, you use nature to teach us about your divine nature. Help us continually to be pruned and to grow and to bear much fruit as the disciples who first heard Jesus. Hear the prayers we offer, grant them to your Son, who lives and reigns with you, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever.
I am the vine and you the branches. Remain in me as I remain in you. You will bear great fruit in me.
new commandment I give you, even as I have loved you, now love one another. I am the vine and you the branches. Remain in me as I remain in you. You will bear great fruit in me. No greater love is there than this, than to lay down your life for your friends. I am the vine and you the branches.
Pray, brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. O God, who by this wonderful exchange effected in this sacrifice, have made us partakers of the one supreme Godhead, grant, we pray, that as we have come to know your truth, we may make it ours by a worthy way of life, through Christ our Lord. The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, at all times to acclaim you, O Lord, but in this time, above all, to laud you yet more gloriously, when Christ our Passover has been sacrificed. By the oblation of his body, he brought the sacrifices of old to fulfillment in the reality of the cross, and by commending himself to you for our salvation, showed himself the priest, the altar, and the lamb of sacrifice. Therefore, overcome with paschal joy, every land, every people, exults in your praise, and even the heavenly powers with the angelic hosts sing together the unending hymn of your glory as they acclaim. You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread, and giving thanks, broke it, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body,
which will be given up for you. In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice. And once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it. For this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith.
We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again, until you come
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity together with Francis, our Pope, and Stephen, our bishop, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, especially D. Albert, Catherine Arguello, Felix Arguello, Melanie Martinez, Leonard Archuleta, Mike Borda, Admiral, U.S. Navy, Deborah Martinez, Teresa Martinez, Celia Martinez, all the deceased members of the Catholic Daughters of the Sangre de Cristo Court, 1810, Annette LeBlanc, Jim Mowry, and Viola V. Hill, and Father James J. McDivitt, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles, Saint Athanasius, Saint Therese of the Child Jesus, patroness of our diocese, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ.
Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, forever and ever.
The fruits of our Lord's passion, death, and resurrection are on the sacred altar of this Eucharistic table, his body, his blood, his soul, his divinity, to nourish us so that we bear good fruit, that is, in the corporal and spiritual works of mercy, and becoming missionary disciples. At the Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread,
and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days. By the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever. Peace of the Lord be with you always. Let us offer each other the sign of peace.
Behold the Lamb of God, behold him who takes away the sin of the world. Blessed are those who are called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed. Our communion antiphon. Together we say, I am the true vine, and you are the branches, says the Lord. Whoever remains in me and I in him bears fruit in plenty. Alleluia.
Make me a channel of your peace. Where there is hatred, let me bring your love. Where there is injury, your pardon, Lord. And where there's doubt, true faith in you. Make me a channel of your peace. Despair in life, let me bring hope. Where there is darkness, only light. And where there's sadness, ever joy. Oh, Master, grant that I may never see so much to be consoled as to console. Understood as to understand, to be loved as to love with all my soul. Make me a channel of your peace. It is in pardoning that we are pardoned, in giving of ourselves that we receive. That we're born to eternal life. We come to share our story. Come to break the bread. We come to know our rising from the dead. We come as your people. We come as your own, united with each other, love finds a home. We come to share our story. We come to break the bread. We come to know our rising from the dead. We are called to heal the broken, to be hope for the poor. We are called to feed the hungry at our door. We come to share our story. We come to break the bread. Life and cup of promise, in this meal we all are one. In our dying and our rising, may your kingdom come. We come to share our story. We come to break the bread. We come to know our rising from the dead. Lord, prepare me to be a sanctuary. True.
Let us pray. Graciously be present to your people, we pray, O Lord, and lead those you have imbued with heavenly mysteries to pass from former ways to newness of life through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
I didn't explain why the Saturday morning liturgy doesn't count for the Sunday obligation. Following our ancestors in faith, the Jewish brothers and sisters, their day began at sunset and ended at sundown the next day. So our liturgical Sunday begins at 4 o'clock by declaration of the Pope, 4 o'clock Saturday, and continues through all day Sunday. So that was Saturday, it wasn't the Sunday obligation. I ask you, if you're interested in attending our diocesan convocation, to see me after Mass. Registrations have ended, but I can probably arrange for you to participate if you wish. So see me after Mass. I'll be in the vestibule as we leave. We do have an evening Mass, a 5 p.m. youth Mass. So those of your family and friends who couldn't make it this morning or last night are welcome to join us at 5 o'clock this afternoon. So we look forward to seeing you soon. The Lord be with you. May the blessing of Almighty God, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit come down upon you and remain with you forever. Go in peace.
Sing to the mountains, sing to the sea. Raise your voices, lift your hearts. This is the day.
This is the day the Lord has made. Let all the earth rejoice.